my name is Barbara. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create an allocation rule and generate allocation journals. In this example, I'm going to distribute the communication cost of $55,000 across the 6 cost centers based on headcount. The chart of accounts has 6 segments: company, line of business, account, cost center, product, and intercompany. The communication cost is recorded in this account. This is the source of the allocation. Headcount is recorded in account 91,000 using the stat or statistical currency, and all 6 cost centers are under parent cost center 700. Let's start by navigating to the Calculation Manager, the tool for managing allocations. Now I'll select the Create Allocation Rules task. The task opens the Enterprise Performance Management workspace. I'll use the navigation menu to open the Calculation Manager. Now I'll expand the S-Base application and find the Balances Cube for the chart of accounts that's associated with the U.S. primary ledger. I'm going to create the rule for the U.S. Chart of Accounts Balances Cube. Since the rule is going to allocate cost based on headcount, let's include headcount in the name. I'll accept the default values for the rest of the fields. The Rule Designer opens in a new tab, which has the name of the rule I just entered. I can drag components from the rule palette to the flowchart in the designer area. Each component under the palette performs a different task. I'll start with the point of view. By setting the point of view, you can default values that are fixed throughout the allocation rule. For example, let's assume a chart of accounts has a future use segment that is currently not used. I can use the point of view to set a default value, such as 000, and then I don't have to select a value for this segment when I'm defining the rule. I'm going to insert the point of view between the beginning and ending components in the flowchart. Now let's set the values in the point of view. The accounting period is supplied by users when the allocation is run, so I'll use a variable instead of a fixed value. Runtime prompt variables make rules dynamic and reusable. I'm going to select the database category. That's the category for the specific cube. The application category applies to all cubes. The accounting period is already defined as a variable, so I don't need to create it. I can just select it here. Now the accounting period will be a prompt at runtime. I'm going to set the rest of the fixed dimensions. For this rule, the ledger, company, line of business, product, and intercompany segments of the chart of accounts will not change. I'll also set the currency and currency type. I can enter each value, or I can use the member selector. Let's use the member selector. First, I'll select the U.S. primary ledger and move it to the Selections panel. Now I'll select the company, then the line of business, the product, and the intercompany segment. I want to set the currency, so I'll add that to the point of view as well. This time, instead of expanding the list, I'll use the search. And finally, the currency type. I'm going to select total. Total means that the allocation is going to use balances in the ledger currency, plus the equivalent ledger currency balances of foreign currency journals, basically using all of the ledger currency amounts. If I had selected entered, the allocation would only use amounts where USD is the entered currency. I've finished selecting all of the point of view dimensions. To recap, I've set fixed values for all of the segments except for account and cost center. Now I'm going to use the allocation component to create the rule for our use case. The wizard is going to guide me through the steps. The first step is the point of view. This point of view is specific to the allocation component, so if I had a rule with multiple allocation components, I could specify a point of view for each of them. Since my rule will only have one allocation component, and I already defined a point of view, I can skip this step. The next step is to define the source. The source is the cost or revenue pool to be distributed or allocated. A source can be a referenced account balance or a user-defined amount. For our rule, the source is the communication cost stored in the communication cost account I showed earlier. To retrieve the cost, I need to provide the account combination. I already specified values for the company, line of business, product, and intercompany segments in the point of view, so the only segments I need to specify here are the account and cost center. I'll start with the account and use search to find 64510. Now I'll select the cost center. Let's go back to the source step and see what other dimensions we need to provide. The remaining three dimensions specify what balance to retrieve from the source account. The scenario dimension has a default value called total for allocations, which is the sum of actual and allocated amounts. Since the source for this rule only involves actual balances, I'm going to change this dimension. I still need a value for the balance amount dimension. The default value for the amount type dimension is period to date, which is the right value for this rule. Let's open the member selector. For the scenario dimension, I'm going to select actual. If I had two rules, with the second rule using the allocations resulting from the first rule, I'd use the allocated scenario for the second rule. Now I'll move on to the balance amount dimension. The rule is going to allocate the communications cost for the period, so I'm going to select period activity. I'm finished with the source and ready for the next step. Now let's define the allocation range. The range is the spread of values that the source will be distributed against. For our use case, I'm allocating across cost centers, and the parent cost center is 700. I don't need to specify an account, so I'll open the member selector from the cost center row. You always have to select a parent value, because you have to allocate across a range of values. Here's the parent cost center. I'll select it from the latest account hierarchy. I'm only allocating across cost centers, so I'm finished with this step. In this next step, I have to specify the target. The target receives the allocated amount. In our example, the communication cost is stored in account 64510, and that's also our target. I'll just enter the value here instead of using the member selector. Ready for the next step. Now I have to define the offset. The offset receives the offsetting debit or credit to balance the allocation that was generated. In our use case, the offset account and cost center are the same as the source, so I'll just copy the account and cost center values. The offset has to be a child value. If you select a parent value, the allocation rule will fail validation. I'm finished with the offset step. I'm not excluding any values from the allocation, so I'll skip this step. This step is critical. The basis determines the ratio in which the source needs to be allocated to each member of the allocation range. The basis could be distributing the source evenly. Or you can select specific statistical or account balances for a particular period as the basis. In our use case, we need to allocate the communication cost based on headcount. The ratio is going to be calculated by dividing a cost center's headcount by the total headcount. Once again, I could use the member selector, but I'll just enter the values directly. I'll start with the account dimension and enter account 91,000, which has the headcount values. The balance amount is going to be the period activity because the total headcount for each cost center is included in one journal, recorded in one period. And the currency for headcount is stat. The values for the other dimensions will be derived automatically based on the point of view and range specified earlier. I'm not going to change any of the options, so let's continue. I need to specify the rounding options here in case of rounding differences when the allocation is generated. Because the allocation is in US dollars, I'm going to enter 2 for the number of decimal places. I'm finally finished with the allocation component, and now I'm going to validate the rule. Validation is an important and required step. Validation checks for consistency against the outline of the balances cube that it references. For example, checking that the offset is a child and not a parent value, and checking that entered values exist. Let's deploy the rule now. Deployment makes the rule we just defined in the Calculation Manager available for generation in the general ledger. We finish creating the rule. Let's generate the allocation journal now. I'll navigate back to the journal's work area. I can generate allocations using the Generate General Ledger Allocations task. I'll select the rule I just defined. And here's the runtime prompt for the accounting period. I also want to post the allocations journal, so I'll leave this setting and submit the process. Now let's find the journal. The name of the journal is the allocation rule name. Here's the journal. Let's review it. Here's the credit to the communication cost account. And here are the debits to the different cost centers based on their headcount. Now that the rule is defined, all we need to do for future accounting periods is generate the allocation journals. Thank you.